This is Raymond at Cool Horse Shop Foreman. On the previous video, we were inside the trailer. Now I'm going to show you on the back side of this water heater how to take the antidote rod out. You'll want to take a socket and, of course, a wrench and take the antidote rod out. Now, you may stand back. This may have pressure. Once you take this antidote rod out, as you can see here, this is a brand new antidote rod. This is one that's been chewed up. You'll want to discard this one and replace it with a new one. On the previous video, we showed you how to put antifreeze inside the trailer. I'm going to show you how to just blow one out. This is the easiest way to do it. Now keep in mind, you will not get the water heater or the pump as far as blowing all the water out. This is basically just a precautionary step. If you live somewhere where it's going to be really cold for a long period of time, you might want to go ahead and put antifreeze in it. This is basically just to get you by. You can also, if you have a barn, a shed, anywhere where you can park your trailer, have it warmed up. You can have ceramic heaters inside, have your doors open. Just make sure, of course, you get it away from furniture, not too close to the walls. You can also do that. Use your furnace. Keep it as about as warm as you can without overdoing it. You can have it at 50 degrees and still be okay. Now, on this side here, I'm going to show you real quick. Right here is a city water connection. They make a fitting here that you can use an air nozzle. Any air hose will work. What you'll need to do is once you get your air hose hooked up to here, you'll have somebody go on the inside and open up all the valves on your toilet, shower, sinks. That is going to blow most of the water out, but it's not going to get it completely winterized. So keep in mind, you will not get the water heater, nor will you get the pump.